your better life is the message to the younger generation, to these people who are coming here, and to the people of the community. Once they see you walking there, I know these people, I know them, there is an aura of God that is covering you, that they have no question whatsoever. I know them, they are believers of God. That modeling is consistent. Okay? Number four, Joseph Ganny conquered the land and the nation and the experience peace. Number two, desire to make the word of God your compassion life. Okay? That's it, meditate. Continue to recite, continue to speaking, continue memorizing the word of God. I tell you what. The Bible is very clear. The word of the Lord is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I read to you. I'll just read. I will not explain. Just Psalms 119. So it's very, very important. A gauge of your prosperity and blessing is not contingent to what we know and what we do. It is based in the foundation of loving the word of God and be stuck to the word of God, your mind to the heart, and live in the word of God. God can never lie. You will be changed by blessing after blessing, and you become a blessing to many. That's the wonderful secret of the Lord. I read to you 119. Here, 119, 119, 197 to 104. 197. Listen to the word of God, just read to you. So let the word explain. 97, here's what he said. Oh, how I love your law. I think about it all day long. Lord, I love your word. I think about it all day long. What am I? Your commands make me wiser than my enemies. So if you have an enemy, we know how their strategy. As you enter into the word of God, you know their strategy, and we know the wisdom of God. Then you say, oh, but man, they know the word of God, they know the word of God. Did you, sir? I'm not also run. The Bible says, oh, how I love you, Lord. I think about it all day. Your commands make me wiser than my enemies. There we are, defeated. Once you have the word of God, I don't want to play around with these people in that girl guys. Oh, don't they know the word of God? For your commands are my constant guide, because we have the guide, Jesus Christ and the Word. 99. Yes, I have more insight than all my teachers. PhD, brilliant, when you have the Word of God, I tell you what, you are more wiser than them. That's why. That's why we have people who are illiterate, studying the Bible by the Holy Spirit, that are more wiser than the brilliant of our time. For I am always thinking your decrees. I am more even wiser than my elders, for I have kept your commandments. I have refused to walk on any path of evil, that I remain obedient to your Lord. Because of the Lord of God, there is no charisma, there is no magnet for anything for you to enjoy. No way! Because you are created by the Word of God, Jesus Christ Himself. The appetite for the pains of the flesh has no more charisma, no more kind of... Is that pleasant for you? No. You are enjoying the word of God. So very important here that desire the word of God, your compass in life. It is your compass, and if you are traveling, the word of God is your GPS. If you don't have the GPS in your life, you will lose. Okay. Lastly, this is the last one. Last one here, verse number 2 here. Desire the word of God and then blessing the Lord of you. Okay, verse 8, and then here we are in verse 7. You'll be successful in everything you do. If you are successful, word of God. Number 1 is be courageous. And then word of God, and don't forget, you know the word of God and do them. Lucky then, the blessing will come upon you. When you will have good success. Number 1, you will be successful in everything you do. Verse 7. Number 8, you will make yourself prosperous. Verse 8. And you will have good success, and it will be only then you will succeed. How? Meditate the word of God day and night. If you do not have blessing, because you do not have the word of God, you do not have The curse of the Lord is in the house of the wicked, and they are like angry sea, tossed back and forth. There is no peace in the house of the wicked. So very important, we are peaceful to the Lord because of the Word of God. So here we are, meditate the Word of God. You want, is it a blessing? Is it a blessing? Promotion, financially, okay? Deuteronomy 1-14 is pronounced by the Lord. One more, and then that will be the final text of the Word of God. 2 Corinthians 8:9, and then 3 John 2, and 2 Corinthians 9:8, and I'll be finishing in a few moments. Because, okay, 2 Corinthians 8:9. Listen to me. When Jesus was hung on the cross, all the curses that was our, you know, what they call that, that is for us, all the curses from mental, emotional, physical, everything, and even we're living in poverty, what happened? Jesus took them all. He became cursed on the tree. What is the meaning of that? He became very and abjectly very poor. So you will become very rich. It covers your mind, emotion, soul, spirit. Finances is a blessing of God. And so you will be blessed also financially. The Bible says, I wish above all things that they may prosper, finances, and be in health, physical, even as your soul prosper, okay, as your soul. So God designed for us to be blessed financially as well. Okay, I want you to read here, 2 Corinthians 9:8, and follow me quickly, 2 Corinthians 9:8. Listen to this and read it over and over again, and this is the key that God is revealing to us into a financial blessing as well. 9:8. And God will generously provide all you need. He'll provide all you need. When you don't provide all you need, you are prosperous. And then because of the day, you will always have everything you need and plenty left over. Listen to the next word, to share with others, especially in the things that pertain to the heavenly kingdom. So this is the plan of God. You will prosper. It is not the sign of the Lord that you will be poor and in need of everything. It isn't, because to be in poverty is a curse. So God will give us food. I am young, you know, I am old, and I have never seen my righteousness forsaken, begging bread. Never. They are lying to back, but they that trust in the Lord shall never lack any good thing. And so God is revealing to us that He planned for us to be prospered, and He also to say in 9:8, and an extra more money, and the extra more money that God will allow us to enjoy is not for you to keep, but for you to disperse. And so as this money is coming to you and be released, it is not stuck. There is a continuous moving of God's blessing and reaching other people in the church world. And God will continue to bless you, mind, body, and spirit. It is God's will for us to be blessed. So generosity is an opening door for us to become a receiver. There is a reciprocal move. You receive, you release. Once you stop, it lacks. And it cannot be trusted by God because it is stuck. It must be a continuous flow as a steward or managers of God's abounding riches. Amen. Okay, I have to hear that. So don't forget to say, Israel experienced the blessings and victory, number one, by serving God to his men wholeheartedly. This was an evil. As we come to this place, as other people explore, Lord, whether are 5 or 10 or 20 or 30, we are not moved by the number. God sees the quality of the heart. So you came by serving God faithfully, like Joseph and Caleb. Number one, your courage of following God in tough times, in good times, in proper time, will be rewarded, become righteous. Okay. Number two, your vision and desire for the word of God to sink in more and more to you. It is your meditation, it is your recital every day. Will bless you. Listen to the next word. You will too become successful. The blessing will follow you. And thirdly, the blessings of victory is for you in 2018. I want you to see this here, and I can put in the book of Joshua. I love this one. See, maybe we hear. Joshua, Deuteronomy, Joshua. The last chapter of Joshua. Joseph said to the people, you are not able to serve the Lord. He is holy God. He is a jealous God. 24 to 19. He will not forgive your rebellion. And you said, if you forsake the Lord and serve part of God, he will turn to this other. Listen to the blessing here. This is the name. Hear what Joseph said. Okay. And the people said to Joseph, we will serve the Lord our God and obey him. On that day, Joseph made a covenant for the people and their Shechem. He reaffirmed for their increase in law. And Joseph recorded these things in the book of the law of God. Then he took a large stone and set up there under the oak, near the holy place. Verse 27. See, he said to all people, this stone will be a witness against us. It has heard all your words that the Lord has said to us. It will be a witness against you if you are untrue or unfaithful to your God. Joshua dismissed the people each to their own inheritance. There's a word here. Okay, here we are. Israel served the Lord. Verse 31. Israel served the Lord throughout the lifetime of Joshua. Blessing. First, okay? Throughout the lifetime of Joshua, Joseph died. In the lifetime of the elders who outlived him, you know, experienced everything the Lord had done for Israel. So here you can see the experience through Joseph's leadership in Canaan. The blessing of God, there was peace, prosperity, good health, possession of the land, to a big, big piece of property, and the expression, Joseph died, and then the leaders. And God is giving to us through the leadership of new pillars today as we communicate this message in 2008, and other people come in, will continue to be an abundant blessing to the guiding light of three important points I mentioned to you towards our blessing and victory. It is already in our hands. It is up to us to move with courage. It is up to us to give importance to the word day in and day out, memorize and meditate the word of God into them. And it is up to us to claim what truly belongs to us, whether you like it or not. You will see the prosperity of your children and grandchildren because of your modeling. That blessing will communicate to up to 1,000 generations. Wow. People of God, 2018 is a time of victory. Receive it in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.